This is an amazing
How'd you
from Iran.
My name is Sophie from Indonesia, Secretary General.
Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you so much.
Sophie, one of our fellows from Indonesia.
I'm Julia from Argentina. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Thank you.
Yes, yes.
In Dag Hammarskjöld.
My favorite person.
I'm a board member. Nice to see you, Mr. SG. And I hope to have another view.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Can we get Mrs. Sophie from the same area? And we are keeping an eye very closely on what happens in South Korea as well as North Korea.
Good.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
We did. Are you ready for
that?
Yeah, we will.
Thank you.
That's right. Roll-ups.
Yeah.
Don't be shy. Can I have a photo with the students? Thank you.
Okay.
Are you based in Buenos Aires?
As you know, in my previous incarnation, I was for many years a journalist, and I cannot say how important it is in the young careers of the professionals to be able to be given such an opportunity as you colleagues of the United Nations Press Corps offer to the four young and already very experienced professionals. I had the chance of meeting them at the beginning when they arrived, and they were all so grateful for the opportunity, so thrilled, and also so excited for what they were going to live through. I've just met the four of them right now, and I asked what were the highlights, and one told me when one of the highlights was the diplomatic encounters that he's been able to see at the Security Council. For the other one was the huge amount of events and activity that was taking place during the General Assembly, etc. But the most important, I think, is that for the four, these weeks spent here with us are going to be unforgettable. So thank you again, dear colleagues that have been organizing this event. Without media and journalists that have opportunities to develop their careers, jobs are very difficult to be done. So I think the offer that they have been having here of spending time with us is unique, and it is because of your generosity and your warm welcome to all of them. Please, let's give them, the four of them, a big applause for the work they've been doing.
My name is Evelyn Leopold. I'm chair of the Dag Hammarskjöld Fund for Journalists and a UN correspondent since 1990, first for Reuters and now a contributor to the Huffington Post. Our indefatigable Secretary General Ban Ki-moon was here earlier before rushing off to another engagement, or maybe two or three, as he doesn't stop. He's honorary chairman of the fund and will even be seeing the four in an interview next week. We also welcome Peter Thompson, the General Assembly President, who was kind enough to stop by and pay his respects. He will also allow himself to be interviewed next week. Anyway, let us applaud both officials for taking the time to come. So welcome. The DAG Fund has existed since 1962, and we sponsor four mid-level journalists, mainly from developing countries, each year to cover the United Nations for 12 weeks in the autumn. And as you can see from this gathering, despite so many years, we are still here. This year, we have a very active quartet. They ask questions at press conferences, they interview as many people as they can, and they have a variety of interests. Of course, they were lucky in being able to write about the selection of a new Secretary General. Is Melissa Fleming here? No, she's supposed to still come. Because we will be seeing more of her also. We are at the United Nations. We are not of the United Nations. This means we raise our own money. And we have been a success for 55 years. The experience that the fellows have had has led them to bigger and better things in many countries in the world. More high-level jobs, writing books, and so forth. And so we hope you will support us and continue to make this a success. We have little, shamefully, I have little envelopes in the back on the blue table that you can take with you and contribute if you feel like it. We also have a sign-in board that I know nobody ever does that, but sometimes I like to know who is here. Shauna McGee, our treasurer, wherever she may be, Shauna, can answer any questions. Back there she is, my goodness, disappearing. We've done that already. Okay, now we're getting ready to introduce the fellows and the one and only Maggie Bashir, Voice of America, and the fund's vice chairman will do so. And in closing, we're proud of the fund and we hope the fellows have benefited from their experience. Maggie?
All right, good evening, welcome. If I haven't welcomed you already, welcome again. So tonight I'm going to introduce our four fabulous fellows to you, Sophie, Rahula, Abdul, and Julia. So first up, and they're gonna tell you a few little details about their time here so far. They're still here with us for about three more weeks. So our first fellow is Sophie Sharif. She's a reporter and producer from Indonesia's Compass TV, where she reports on elections, corruption, politics, terrorism, you name it. Sophie's the recipient of an International Reporting Prize for her piece on Indonesia's microeconomy. At the UN, she has filed live TV reports on a variety of topics. Sophie has also reported endlessly on the Paris Climate Agreement, finally shaming her government into ratifying the accord. No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding on the last part, but they did deposit their ratification instrument just yesterday, so you tell me whether that's a coincidence. So I bring you Sophie Sharif.
Thank you, Maggie. Ladies and gentlemen, I remember being very disappointed last year, having learned about the Doc Hammarskjöld Fellowship 2 days after the application deadline had passed. But I'm really glad that I am a year too late for the program. The tensions that have arisen all over the world are somewhat a unique experience and lesson for me. I come from the biggest Muslim country in the world, so there is an especially huge interest in issues regarding the conflicts in Syria, in Iraq, as well as in Yemen, which intensified this past year. In general, there are no Indonesian journalists in the front lines of those conflicts. The news we have from these countries comes mainly from international news agencies. Now, with me being here, I can at least deliver a new additional layer of reporting to help viewers in Indonesia understand better about what is actually going on. I get to observe how diplomacy is being used, sometimes successfully, sometimes not, and interpret it in a way that resonates with the audience in my country. To a certain degree, it reshapes how I report international politics, and this will definitely affect my future work in the field. Moreover, I have to say that I was seriously mind blown when I saw both Ambassador Power and Ambassador Churkin pointing fingers at each other on Syria in the council and in front of media. How these veteran diplomats work sharp questions from the media is really amazing and captivating to watch. This year's fellowship has been the gift that keeps on giving. I was lucky enough to be here to see the process of the Secretary General selection in a more open manner, which I know has never been done before. The fellowship also coincides with what may probably be the most important and perhaps the most ridiculous presidential election in the world. This year's US election is just a tasty side dish of our UN deliberations main course. So, this whole fellowship has been an amazing ride. Seeing international diplomacy at work from the front row seat is an incomparable experience. I thank you, the donors, as well as Evelyn Leopold and the board of the Dag Hammarskjöld Fellowship for your extremely hard work to get the four of us here. Please keep up the good work for as long as you can, because I know there are many journalists out there who are going to be as grateful as I am for an opportunity like this. Thank you very much.
See, I told you they're fabulous. They're always fabulous. We pick fabulous fellows. Our second fabulous fellow is Rohela Faghighi. He's our first Iranian fellow in many, many years. He works for Entekab News Agency in Tehran, where he reports in Farsi, and he's an English language contributor on Iranian affairs for The Guardian's independent news organization, the Tehran Bureau, as well as the Middle East Eye and Al Monitor. At the UN, Rohela has concentrated on the Syrian crisis, the conflict in Yemen, and meetings between Iranian P5 plus one officials. Rohela.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm coming from a country which is a major player in the Middle East, and being in the UN as a journalist following the Security Council meetings and other events has given me a new insight into the Syrian and Yemeni crisis. Experiencing the General Assembly, which was a busy event, brought me one level up from my previous status, as I learned tremendously through having access to various officials, ambassadors, and of course, professional journalists from all over the world. Taking part in the press conferences of the foreign ministers of different countries, such as France and Russia, and special rapporteurs of the UN, was a unique chance to ask my questions. In fact, talking with diplomats at the UN and attending briefings, as well as generally expanding my knowledge of world developments, helped me in reporting and writing analytical articles. I also wrote exclusive stories regarding the Syrian talks in Switzerland. My piece in English about Egypt and Iraq joining the negotiations was a scoop, and most outlets in Iran quoted me. The same thing happened when I reported on the UN Secretary General election. Being here also allowed me to cover the trip of Iran's president to UNGA, a trip which was important because of some problems in the way of nuclear deal implementation. Furthermore, I covered the president's press conference as well as his meetings with 5+1 officials. While my main focus here has been on the Syrian crisis, I tried to take advantage of my presence at the UN by reporting on the stories which do not get too much coverage in Iranian media, including the choice of Yazidi activist Nadia Murad as a UN Goodwill Ambassador. I applied for a few journalism fellowships in the US at the same time, and I was accepted in three of them. But the Dag Hammarskjöld was the one I chose because I thought I could learn a lot through witnessing the General Assembly and Security Council meetings close up and the negotiations for resolving the global problems, a lifetime experience that I couldn't get anywhere else. I'm proud to be one of the first Iranians in many decades who has been awarded this fellowship. But despite all the difficulties I went through for getting the US visa, I hope other journalists from my country are given this career-changing opportunity and take their professional developments to a higher standard. Thank you.
Thank you, Rahala. Our next fellow is Julia Arana, who works for Comunicarse. It's a Spanish language online publication specializing in sustainable development and corporate social responsibility. Julia has been very active, she's an Argentine national, born in Bolivia. Julia has been very active on the interview front during her time here, conducting interviews with experts and officials on the Global Compact, women's empowerment, antimicrobial resistance, and various aspects of climate change, from financing to its impact on agriculture. Please welcome Julia Arana.
Thank you, Maggie. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us today. I'm honored that you recognize me as a fellow journalist. Reporting from the UN General Assembly and digging firsthand information about the UN deliberation process is the most exciting thing I've ever done in my career. I had the chance to interview many important people, from world leaders to professor from the most respected universities to NGO specialists. I'll never forget I have the opportunity to talk to Peter Thompson, our PGA, during a reception like common people talk and make jokes about how some journalists might be waiting until Christmas to find out who's the next Secretary General. I'm glad that we have the opportunity to see Mr. Guterres' election, although I wouldn't mind to stay here longer. My daily work at Comunicarse is dedicated to covering the latest news on sustainable development so Latin American companies are properly informed and able to make decisions upon sustainability. Shana calls me the SDG nerd. So I was really excited to interview Ms. Liz Kingo, Executive Director of UN Global Compact. I was pleased to hear that the UN Global Compact is assuming the role of challenging companies to make real commitments to fight climate change. For example, establishing a price on carbon emissions. So the Paris Agreement doesn't stay simply plans on paper. I also feel lucky that I could witness the leading role of Latin America in General Assembly throughout Colombia's role in promoting peace process. I think it's important for the international community to continue to show to the Colombians and to everyone else that they believe in negotiated ends to armed conflict. As journalists, we have an important role in this regard. Finally, I believe that journalism is an occupation that has to be done with passion, experience, and knowledge. I came here with a heart and mind full of passion, and the DAC Fellowship gave me tools to make me improve as a journalist, facing new challenges, interviewing diplomats, and engaging with more experienced journalists. I deeply value that this fellowship is run by professional journalists that share my same passion for our field. So I encourage my colleagues in Bolivia, Argentina, and all Latin American countries to apply to the DAC Fellowship. I am leaving New York with the aim of bringing the DAC Fellowship closer to my colleagues. Thank you very much.
All right, and if I could just have your attention for a few more minutes, our final fellow is Abdulfatuh Shafiev, a freelancer from Tajikistan, where he was a pioneer of online journalism. Abdul's an editor for the Central Asia Analytical Network, created by the George Washington University, and a contributor to Global Voices Online. He was a Fulbright scholar and has covered events in Europe, the Middle East, and Central Asia. At the United Nations, he works in three languages, Russian, Tajik, and English, and has concentrated on Central Asian nations. Abdul has written analysis pieces on the concepts of authoritarian governments, freedom of speech, and media freedom while he's been here. So please welcome our final fellow, Abdul.
It's not easy to be in the focus of attention. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to be the very first representative from Central Asia selected to be a DAG Fellow. It has been an opportunity to give my audience a new, different glance into what's going on at the United Nations. I have been covering UN events in three languages, mainly in Russian and sometimes in English and Tajik. I have been reporting on interesting issues not only for my country, Tajikistan, but also for the whole region of Central Asia, all five stans. In the beginning, when I was sending the routine news from the UN, my editors were skeptical that it would be possible to get something really newsworthy. But then the UN Secretary General told presidents of some countries who are being elected for decades in a row how this is a bad idea ruling a country for 20 plus years. When I was writing ruling, my spell check kept changing the word into ruining, which is actually also true in this case. Dragging those few words from Ban Ki-moon's speech and linking it into the political situation in my region has so far been the story that made the most impact and got the largest response from my audience. We are happy to be a lucky team of fellows this year, witnessing two highly interesting elections in two United Nations and states. While already being the first in our countries to tweet and Facebook and report on who became the main guy in the United Nations, we are looking forward to report on who will be the main lady in the United States next week. I'm grateful to everyone who voted for me during the selection process. Thanks for giving this old and bold man a chance to be here today. Big thanks to Evelyn, who takes care of us a lot. Thanks to Bill for watching the debates with us. To Shona for showing us new interesting art in Brooklyn. To Mary for helping us with logistics. To Margaret and everyone else for their support and recommendations. And most importantly, this unforgettable experience would not take place if not for the generous donors of the program. You gave us a wonderful opportunity to enhance our knowledge, empower our skills, educate our audiences on the United Nations, strengthen our capacities as journalists, and experience the wonderful spirit of the Times Square. Thank you.
They get better every time they speak. I would like to close the program, but I notice another honored guest among many honored guests here, the Undersecretary General for Peacekeeping, Mr. Eve Latsous, who's come to our lunches and who's really supported the fund. Would you like to say a few words? Actually, he got roped into it.
Thank you, Evelyn. Yes, you did rope me in. Good evening, everyone. But it is true that I am genuinely pleased, as in years past, to attend this gathering of the Dag Hammarskjöld Fellowship for Journalists. I think this is a splendid initiative. It's been going on for many years. And as you said, madam, journalism is indeed about passion, about knowledge, and about experience. One could say the same about diplomats, by the way. But it is something that we share. And indeed, giving young journalists from all over the world the possibility to get to a deeper knowledge of what the UN is about, I think that is a very valuable initiative. It is actually an investment in the future, because the UN needs to be written about by people who know what it's about. The UN is perhaps not the most perfect organization in the world, but if it didn't exist, it would have to be invented. My regret, Evelyn, though, is that we don't see enough Francophone. We have speakers of Farsi, of Tajik, of Spanish, of Bahasa Indonesia, a language which I'm happy to speak also. But what about La Francophonie? Huh? I know there have been some fellows in the past, But I would urge you, please, to not neglect that language, of which I happen to be rather fond. So thank you very much for this wonderful initiative, continued initiative. Thank you for all the work and dedication you put into it. And of course, to this year's four fellows, well, all the best, and my best wishes for your careers. We rely on you saying what is the UN about, with its grandeur, with its shortcomings sometimes, but it needs to be written about again. It's a wonderful institution. So thank you very much indeed. Merci.
Merci. Andre Huh?
Okay, everybody, continue drinking. It's the end of our formal program. And if you remember, sign your name on the way out so I know who's here, because I'm getting senile and I can't remember everyone. Take care.